So, I want you all to first ask yourself, am I creative? Now, some of you may be saying, yes, I consider myself to be creative. I actually enjoy coming up with new and original ideas, and that's great. But some of you may be saying, I'm not the creative type. I'm not the one who's usually coming up with the cool and original ideas, so I don't feel qualified to call myself creative. So why is it that we've been dividing ourselves into the creative and the non-creatives? I often hear people saying, I'm not the creative type. So I want to start by telling you my story. So I go to take art classes once every week, and sometimes in my art class we would join together the younger kids and the older kids to work in the same class. And so when this happens, I would be able to see what the younger kids are working on. So one day, the younger kids were working on drawing this fruit basket that was nicely sorted in front of them. And so this one girl, she's drawing this fruit basket, and around 30 minutes into class, her drawing looks pretty realistic, and I thought it looked pretty nice. But then she starts adding these crazy colors in the background and these vibrant colors to the fruits. So then her friend looks over and tells her, why'd you do that? That's not what we were supposed to draw. But then this girl tells her friend, why not? Because the teacher did specifically tell us what we had to draw. And so she carries on with her drawing. This took me back to when I was younger. Whether it was I was trying out a new activity, I would have really opted to just go for it. And sometimes this would end with a room full of messy paint and a lecture from my mom about why I have to think before I act. But the point is, I wouldn't be scared to just go for it. So I don't think many of us look back to our childhood and realize how good we were at coming up with spontaneous ideas flowingly. But the thing is, we don't look back to ourselves as good at being creative, because back then we didn't have this idea that anything can be restricting our creative thoughts. So we were a lot more comfortable coming up with our original ideas. And so I, along with many designers and artists, call this kind of thinking creative confidence. So creative confidence is about believing that you have the ability to be innovators and artists. It's about believing in your ability to be coming up with your original and unique ideas. And so I think we are more comfortable being innovators and artists when we were younger, more comfortable coming up with new and original ideas. Take, for instance, Pablo Picasso. He's one of the most iconic painters in the arts, and his work are all very intriguing and captivating. He's known for pioneering cubism, as well as inventing collages. And so one of his famous quotes were, it took me 4 years to paint like Raphael, but a lifetime to paint like a child. So before his work on cubism, Pablo Picasso's early work portrayed scenes, well, pretty realistically. And so what I think he was trying to say here was that it's harder to be in touch with your creative expressive self, just like a child who's a lot more comfortable painting based on what they feel, compared to like technical skills that you could develop over a couple of years. So another one of his famous quotes were, every child is an artist. The problem is how to remain an artist once you grow up. So that had me thinking, why is it that when we grow older, it's harder to be in touch with your creative confidence? Why is it harder to be coming up with our original ideas? So tracing back to my childhood, I thought about how as we become older, we start to become much more critical about the world, and when our work is put into public, we face some criticism. But these criticism and hard lessons of reality can make us doubt our abilities to be creating something new. And so when this happens, we start growing apart from our creative confidence, and we don't see ourselves as creative anymore. So I want to bring up another important individual. His name is David Kelly. He is the CEO of design company called IDEO. And he states that creative confidence opts out at a young age. But this idea that we're not creative becomes ingrained in us as we grow older. So I think that was true for myself too. Whether it was I was working on like school project or simply just an art piece, 80% of myself would be thinking about the actual content of the work. But then there was always somewhere inside of me that would be thinking about what others have to say, or would be worrying about what others would say. So then now you may be wondering, well then how do we possibly regain our creative confidence? But I believe that creative confidence is not complex. I mean, it sounds like some perplexing skill, but we can treat it the same way when we're trying to build confidence. And I think that there are three basic steps. So the first one is curiosity. So being curious is about asking more questions, finding what interests you or what intrigues you. And when we do this, we start to get involved in whatever it is you're working on. And it's almost more of a distraction from thinking about anything else that's not related to whatever it is you're working on. The next one is taking action or being active. This is also part of trying to involve yourself in the content of the work. So at the end of the day, it's not enough to just think about what you're working on. Going out and being active is what will bring you that creative spark. So if you do have an idea, whether it is one of try drawing more than what you see, or just simply try and build something new, don't be afraid to take action and try it out. Which brings me to the next idea, which is cherishing mistakes. So everybody will make mistakes, and there would be a point where things won't go as the way you hope. And so avoiding like criticism is inevitable. And it's part of growing up, and it's also part of how we learn. So I've read a book last summer, it's called The Glass Castle by Jeanette Walls, and came across this great quote. So in the book it says, things usually work out in the end, and if it doesn't, you're just not at the end yet. So this was really relieving and encouraging for myself, because whenever things weren't working out for me, I would just tell myself, I'm just not at the end yet. And I realized that I'm much more productive when I'm trying to work back up from my mistakes. But just disregarding your mistakes, or if things aren't going the way you hope, it's important to know that you become much more stronger when you're trying to work back up from your mistakes. So creative confidence allows us to be more comfortable coming up with our unique or original ideas. But I think it's important for us as young learners, and even for adults, to know that creative confidence is more of a progressive method. And you can't truthfully change in one day and say to yourself that I have creative confidence. But then I think it's important for all of us to know that it's important for all of us to not be afraid to call yourself creative, because after all, we can all be creative innovators and artists. Thank you very much.